monster? Is it a monster? What's that coming over the hill? Is it a monster? Is it a monster?
Good morning! Right. Good morning and welcome to BPA Skydive, the Expo 2018. Now, I need you very quickly to do me one favour. It's for everybody to stand up. Come on, everybody stand up very quickly. There will be some freebies thrown out for this as well. Now, what I need you to do is clap. Just means I've got a good picture for when Martin comes on stage we can use later. Okay, I did say I'd throw some stuff out. So over there. In the middle. And over there. They are BPA buffs, which will eventually become history at some point as we change the logo. Right, guys. Firstly, last year the chair gave me a bit of a hard time. What's happened to me, Blipper? Oh, there it is. Chair gave me gave me a bit of hard time because I used 15 minutes of time doing things that I shouldn't have been. So I thought, oh, that deserves a... You got it. Okay, and last year was where we did a bit of hypnotism, my amazing attempt at hypnotising a young lady who was somewhat a little bit nervous of people with a little less hair. So we managed to do that. So this year, there's not going to be anything. Exactly. So, talk about today. So today, we certainly got a lot of new exhibitors and seminars as well. And we tried to look at bringing you some different things from the norm, from skydiving. So what we do have today is one of our speakers. Please come on. It's a guy called Christian Idion, Superbikes rider. And the reason we did this is just to bring the different dynamics of another sport, which has got some exhilaration, performance, and what it is they go through to do their job. So he's very brave, and I know he's actually brought his mum with him today. But to be fair, his mum is Weed Stoodley, who we know is a free flyer anyway, and has held many other records or been on record attempts. So we're really looking forward to that session. And later on during the day, we've got Bill Booth, father of skydiving, who's going to share 50 years of experience and knowledge and the stuff that he's done. So really very much look forward to that. Of course, during the day, we have all these other speakers too. So I'd like you to give a big round of applause for them to bring their experience and knowledge and giving their time today and travel to far. And again, for with the exhibitors, we certainly brought a couple of new ones. We've got the Red Devils out there as well. There's only one here, so hey, we can pick on him, not a problem. So also, one which is quite an interesting one is a company called Pennant. For those of you who, like me, just like fair weather skydiving, they've got a skydiving simulator, so you can do some canopy flying out there as well today. So maybe you can practice some of those things we shouldn't do and not injuring yourself. So it's all on virtual reality. So that should be good. That's out in the atrium. So I think it's also important to... Now, you didn't know what that was for, did you? One of the big things at the end of the day is the prize draw. Last year, it was way too long. This year, it's going to be a lot shorter. You lot are ahead of me this morning, aren't you? You really are. Okay, so we are going to make it shorter. Last year, there was just so much stuff, but we're going to do it a little bit different. But don't forget the rules for the prize draw. Is you need to be in the room, you need to be registered, and you've got about 5 seconds to put your hand up. If not, somebody else will get redrawn. Also, as we know, a couple of years ago, some people came up and collected prizes, and it wasn't really the person we pulled out. So we will be doing random ID checks again. And if it is found that it is incorrect, you have to buy the whole room a beer. It's very, very simple, so please don't buck the system. Okay, so what I want to do is something just to mention is the team that sits behind today. There's 4 of us. So there's myself, there's Martin Shuttleworth, Secretary General. Has Helen Lucas, wherever Helen is, I said I'd mention her. Oh, she's there. She said she wouldn't stand up. So Helen's one of the admin team at the office. She also takes the minutes for the competitions committee. She tells me this is the highlight of a week every 2 months. So I'm glad we're making somebody happy. Blimey. That was genuine. So to get where we are today, and this year we've added a couple more people to the team. So we've got Ali Woodhouse and Mac and McDonald. Ali is the one on the left. So these guys, I said it was a publicly available photograph. GDPR and all the rest of it. So this is Ali doing Baywatch in the Northeast, apparently over Christmas. So Ali is a volunteer onto the communications committee, and she's taken on a humongous task of putting all the seminars together this year. She's done a great job for us, so really, really much appreciated. And then Macca is our digital editor for the magazine, but he's been running all the social media, but also designed the website for the expo. So thank you very much to those guys. But also, not forgetting our sponsors. So Dialogue, Romero, and our new insurer, XL Catlin. So they deserve. Also, the one I did need to mention as well, which is Marie from EventPro. She manages all the exhibitors and looks after us on the day here and ably assists me at the prize draw as well. So, as I said a few minutes ago, we'd have a little quick bit of fun. Now, we all like setting records, don't we? I love this. There's no more of those, I'm afraid. So at my local drop zone, I've run a few games, and we've always kind of beaten this record. And so I'm going to try it very quickly this morning, Martin. It won't take long. What I want to do is try and beat this record by an extra 6.5 inches. So I need a volunteer, male or female, just to come down to the front. You won't be on the stage, so you won't be that embarrassed. Who's coming? Please give me a volunteer. Stevie Murphy. Right, let's have somebody. Otherwise, I'll just come and find somebody to pick on. Ah, oh, there's a lovely lady there. Come on down, as they say. And what's your name?
Sandra.
Where are you from, Sandra?
Wigan.
All right, okay. And what's your local drop zone?
Cark.
Cark. Cark's in the house. Right, what I need you to do is sit in this chair. We're going to make this very quick. We're only going to give it a couple of attempts. You may have seen this elsewhere. I haven't invented this myself, I have to say. I need you to put this tape measure in your mouth. Hold it between your teeth, darling, with your mouth open. Excuse fingers. Right. You know what's going to happen, don't you? You've got to get this all the way down, and you're going to beat the record. You'll be a record holder for Cark. So this against Black Knights will be an interesting one. Because the last holder was a guy called Matty Halford. Oh, we're almost there. We're almost there. Oh, we're at the end. 26 foot and 6.25 inches.
Right. Ready? You can't hold it. In your mouth all the way.
I think if you touch your mouth, we'll take that as a win. You get to keep the box of Maltesers.
Maltesers do melt in your mouth and your hand.
So, guys, that was a boo for Matty Holford, by the way. Okay. Now, guys, I hope you have a splendid day. Those of you who did download the app, which is great and much appreciated, it's a new innovation we're trying. When you go to the seminars and you're completed, you've got the opportunity to score them very simply. If you can, that would be great. It helps us give some feedback, but also plan for the following year. So without further ado, it's time for Martin, who's looking very nervous there, because he doesn't know what his intro music is.
Remember, Martin Salisbury, your chairman, no liking, no lighting. Here you go, Martin.
It feels like every year it becomes more of Adrian's show and less of the AGM. But anyway, I'm seeing it on the floor, but there we go. Thank you. And it kind of takes a different dive, doesn't it, as soon as I stand up. Yeah, less laughs, less applause. So as per last year, what we're going to be doing is running it via an agenda, as per a normal AGM. So you get information of what's up there. Yes, welcome everyone. That's it. Agenda item two is apologies for absence. So these gentlemen have sent in their apologies. Craig and John are our delegates to IPC, delegate and alternate delegates, which unfortunately is running at the same time in Sofia in Bulgaria. So that's their excuse for not being here. Why Phil and Jim aren't here, I don't know. Yeah, it's been boring. Agenda item three is to confirm the minutes from last year's meeting. So I'm looking for a proposer in the room. Thank you very much. A seconder in the room. Anyone against accepting the minutes? Anyone abstaining? They're passed. God, we're whipping through things. Agenda item four is to receive my highlights of the year and also to talk about the strategy. Sadly, in 2017, we had one BPA member killed at a British drop zone, which is Carl Marsh. But also, through the year, we lost the following people. Jim Barnes, Geordie Charlton, Terry Crawley, Steve Collins, Gordon Fernie, John Gibbs, Denislav Ivanov, Peter Lang, Carl Marsh, Jim McConnell, John Noakes, David Oddie, Tom Ridgway, Malcolm Rowley, Frank Graham Sinclair, Andy Sinclair, Jim Wolseley, and Shirley White. I ask you now to stand in a minute's silence for absent friends. Thank you. For the last couple of years, I've always kind of stood here and said, oh, there's lots of change going on and lots of things happening. And I always get the feeling that people sit there and nod and go, yes, yes, great, great. It's all happening at council level and it doesn't really affect me, and you know, I'll know when it does. And so last year was another good example of that. At council, we had lots of change. We had, for the first year, people on three-year tenures. I was elected as chairman for 3 years. We had the two new independents who joined us. We started making some other governance changes. But those are things you think don't really affect us. Well, this year there's been some things that have. One of the major changes, obviously, was the actual opening of the new building. We had that on the 17th of February. We had Dillis, the oldest skydiver, come and open that for us. And that was really great. We had Matthew Stevens join us as well, his youngest skydiver. And Dillis, if you're watching, good luck. She's not been very well, so I hope she's getting better. We also had, the Rise Up, the Yazzie, the mentoring program. We had a first full year of that. And she'll be 3 o'clock in the conference room one. We'll be talking about that. And she's got a stand, I believe, out in the exhibitors as well. So if you haven't already signed up as a mentor or mentee on that, please do. That's great. I'd also like to thank my council, which also includes two co-optees, Debbie as treasurer and Jeff as chair of STC. Also, as always, lots of volunteers who make the BPA run very successfully. Individuals such as all the chairs of my major committees, the archivists, and Graham, who's also chair of IT Strategy Group. Dr. John Carter, Tash, who stood in as acting judges coordinator. So there are lots of individuals who give their time very freely. When I was putting this slide together, I couldn't help but notice that Craig's obviously making a bid for the most titles of anyone. And I had to shorten them, which I don't think he was that impressed with. Obviously, not just the volunteers, but the staff as well, who without selfless work, we wouldn't be able to do half the stuff we do. And a special mention, of course, to Tony as COO, Jeff, STO, and Martin Shuttleworth as our Secretary General, who very much do keep me on the straight and narrow as things go on. Also, our independents, who have now spent a year with us. And if you read the review, the BPA review of the year, you'll see their thoughts on their first year with us. Their help has been invaluable throughout the year. They unfortunately got involved in a panel of inquiry, which they managed very successfully. They've also been involved in our strategy group, and a bit more of that later, which is very, very good. But again, it just brings a whole different perspective. They don't give a damn whether you can wear a helmet on B license, full face helmet on B license, when you can wear a camera. That's not what they're interested in. They're interested in how we run as an organisation. Are we run well? Are we successful? That's really good. So some numbers. These are the membership year April 2016 to March 2017. As you can see, again, record numbers, both of students breaking through the 60,000, full-time members, 6,400, and also of temporary memberships. However, we all remember the summer last year wasn't great. So what we're actually seeing is a slight reduction, and we're blaming the weather for this, in retention of full members. Now, a little worrying stat, because it's the first drop that we've seen year on year for 6 years, or 7 years, sorry. So that's something we want to keep an eye on. And really that comes down to everyone in this room, sharing the love with our A and B license people, making people feel part of the family when they get their licenses and want to stay. So please keep on doing the things that we've been doing. Come up with new ideas how to actually retain people in this sport. That's very important. Again, students trained. We've seen a dip of just over 4,000 from last year's record high to just under the 60,000. And again, we blame that on weather dependencies. I think the drop zones are working as hard as they can to put students through. We just get affected a little bit by the weather. Obviously, this year's going to be fantastic weather. And again, jump numbers, we see that dipping slightly. So come on, guys, you're not jumping enough. Do more jumping. Royal Aero Club, every year we put forward names of individuals we think are worthy of recognition in the wider aviation world. And this year was no different. And last Thursday was the awards ceremony, the awards committee for Royal Aero Club. And brilliantly, that we were the one person we nominated for award, got it. So congratulations, Dan. Now, unfortunately, he can't be here with us, I think, today. Is? Ah, brilliant. Go, leave now. I'm going to talk about you. No. So he had a great year, 2017. As you see, national champion, freestyle, VFS, CP. Won a bronze medal and the World Cup, and also has been awarded the Task Causa Experience Guard Hour of the Year Award. Award ceremony 17th of May, Royal Air Force Club in Central London. Date your diary, Dan. All right. Also, the Royal Aero Club does bursaries, the Royal Aero Club Trust. Last year, 23 bursaries awarded to BPA members aged between 16 and 21, and there's an additional add-on bursary up to the age of 24. If you are in those age groups, and I think there might be a few people in this room, please do apply. It is literally money for nothing, £400 or £500 to help you achieve rating, stamps, ratings, whatever within the sport. other things that we've achieved in 2017. And I said earlier, you know, you feel a lot of things happen at council level and don't really impact you as a member. Last year, I talked about We Love British Skydiving. And to me, what the difference meant about being a parachutist and being a skydiver. And in reality, we're already a long way down that route. We call this, you know, the Skydive Expo. We refer to it as the Skydive Mag. You know, a lot of us refer to ourselves as skydivers. You look at the drop zones, majority of them refer to them as skydive, wherever. But we as a council took that a little further. We did a consultation with you as the members. That did honestly came out a bit 50-50 whether you liked parachuting and whether you liked skydiving as what we do as an organisation. But one of the key markets we're looking at is actually what does the public think? So we commissioned a YouGov report, to actually see how the public react to parachuting and skydiving. And twice as many members of the public understood what we did as an association, if we were referred to as British Skydiving. If we were, you know, British Parachute Association, Association of Parachute Manufacturers, is that what you do? It was confusion, whereas British Skydiving they understood. We also looked at what other national governing bodies do. And here's some examples. And again, it's very much that format, British, what it says on the tin. British canoeing, British swimming, British Cycling. So, in 2017, in October, Council made a decision that we will be rebranding as British Skydiving. As a legal entity, we will still be British Parachute Association. Our articles of association, our bank accounts, our legal agreements, such as with the CAA, with our exposition. But for all trading purposes, branding purposes, we will be British Skydiving. So you will become British Skydivers. I knew you'd be excited by that. It's wild. Wild, I tell you. Those council meetings fly by. but we, the name was pretty easy. The logo, I'm not so sure. So, we're in the process of looking at different ideas around the logo. But, you know, you get 14, 15 people around a table, you get 28 opinions, don't you, on logos. So it's easy. We're going to narrow it down to 3 or 4, and then you, as a membership, are going to choose the logo. That way there's no blame attached to me. these are just some working ideas and you know, some base concepts, and we'll go from there. And I'm sure everyone will have an opinion, and I look forward to hearing them. The other thing was, for the last 5 years, from 2013 to 2017, we've had these set strategic goals, which I harp on about, and everyone goes, yes, 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 and immediately forgets as soon as they leave the room, which are great. Do what they say on the tin. But they have a lifetime, so they finished last year. So Nick, very kindly, decided to he would lead our strategy working group, along with another group of individuals, have come up with a new set of strategic goals for us as an association, which again council has accepted, and we're putting forward to you guys. These are to engage with communities. Those communities are you, our members, our stakeholders, drop zone owners, CAA, our insurers, our commercial partners, but also beyond that, with the general public and with the media. To strengthen British skydiving, to put in place practices and processes that better serve you as members. To enhance the perception of British skydiving, to inspire the passion in you as our members, and also to retain and recruit new members. Assure the financial sustainability of British skydiving, not just for the next 4 or 5 years, but actually for long-term future. That means looking at our income streams, means looking at our financial structures, looking at our budgets, the way we do our budgeting. Representing British skydiving. Now that's not just internationally in terms of competitions and things like that, but actually in terms of the political scale. Again, internationally within our sport, but also with CAA, with the government, going out there and actually making sure that we make our voices heard. A lot of change going on within the aviation sector, but also within the legal framework with which we operate. And make British skydiving resilient. By that, what we mean is making sure that we actually have the structures internally that make us compliant, legally, financially, but also governance-wise. And there's a lot of, as I said, you know, a lot of legislation coming down the line, which has nothing to do with skydiving. We're talking about safeguarding, we're talking about GDPR. For those that don't know what GDPR is, General Data Protection Rules, regulations. It's an EU regulation that's coming in on the 25th of May and will affect everybody and everything. Anybody holds data on anything. So not just the BPA, that would be the drop zones, but also every company you work for, every company you interact with will be affected. Nothing to do with skydiving, but it's a huge cost and pain that we have to go through. And there'll be more of these kind of things coming at us. Now, I can hear you now saying this tonight as you hand me a pint at the bar. Martin, let me ask you a question. And I'll go, thank you very much. Yes, ask me a question. And you'll go, well, these are just words, aren't they, Martin? And sorry, and just to avoid any confusion, that process, pint, question, can be repeated quite a lot tonight. So, Guinness, sorry, if anyone was interested. These are just nice words. Sounds lovely, doesn't it? This is something Nick's kind of got out of his toolbox of nice marketing talk. And yes, you could look at it that way. It could be words. We could do this document. We could sign it. We could put it away in a nice drawer somewhere and go, isn't that fantastic? And you'll go, great, Martin will talk about it next year at the AGM and we don't need to worry. And that is fine. But actually, no. The idea is this is our structure. Everything we will do as your organisation will feed back to that structure. Does it meet one of those strategic goals? If it doesn't, why are we doing it? And I'll give you the example, rebranding British skydiving. We, you know, did our research, as I said, we've looked long and hard at it, but where does it actually meet any of those strategic goals? It's all about engaging with communities. Well, immediately, you refer to yourselves as skydivers, so it immediately engages with you guys a lot better than parachutists. We're not front and back kit, lace-up French para boots, motorcycle helmets anymore. Okay, Scotty, I apologise, you might still be, but majority of us aren't. But also engaging with the communities, so the public, the press, they understand what skydiving is, they see it, they've seen it in the movies, they see it on YouTube clips, they know. So therefore they know who we are, British skydivers, what we represent. So it builds those communities. Enhance the perception of British skydivers. Again, people understand who and what we are, but also It sounds like a modern sport. It sounds like an exciting sport. Is that not what we want to be a part of? And it helps us represent British skydiving. I use the example of, Tony's walked into rooms and introduced himself as coming from British Parachute Association. And, you know, he genuinely was asked, "So is that, do you represent the manufacturers of parachutes?" Whereas, you know, British skydiving, people understand what that means. It fits the format of other governing bodies. So actually we can have presence and people understand who and what we are. Does that all make sense? I had another slide up, which actually was referring to our PIMS, the Personal Information Management System that we've been talking about. Unfortunately, on Thursday, we got a phone call from the company, Tangent, who we've engaged with to do that, and that they basically said, "It's all a bit too difficult, this. Ooh, we don't want to do it anymore. You can have your money back." Yes, I thought that as well, actually. I said actually a few choicer words. But that doesn't stop our desire to actually implement PIMS. So once, because obviously Chair of Development, which is Craig's out in Sofia at the moment, once him and Adrian have had the opportunity to actually talk, we will be deciding the way forward, which will be going out again to tender, providing, getting a new supplier, and we'll be going ahead with it. Why? Because it meets our strategic goals. Having a good membership database which allows us to communicate with you as our members engages. You know, it allows us to, for you to say, "Do you know what, I've just got into FreeFly. So anything involving FreeFly emails, can you send me? Coaching roadshows, competitions, I'd like to know about it." You can register your kit on it. So instead of finding out there was a safety notice on your AAD, God forbid, you know, when you turn up to the drop zone and actually your kit's grounded, you'll know straight away and you can deal with it as and when. These are ways of engaging with the communities. Enhances the perception of British skydiving. We have a modern web-based membership system. So we will be driving that forward. That will be continuing. That's a lot of change. And a part of this strategy, we will be looking, as I said, about the financial systems. We'll also be looking at our internal structures. That means our committees. We will be looking at competitions, development, communications, STC. Are they fit for purpose? Are these the committees right to deliver the services you need as members? And we need to hit our strategic goals going forward. Now that will mean some quite difficult conversations. And we will want to consult with you as members and to hear. But that means that we as an organisation need to have some values to be able to get the maximum value from that. So first of all, it's commitment to excellence. Sounds pretty straightforward, doesn't it? But actually, it means querying everything we do, making sure actually we're doing it for the right reasons to get value, to really make sure we're excelling. Not just as the best membership organisation in skydiving, but why not the best membership organisation? And that also includes safety. I stand up here every year and say how our safety record is the envy of the rest of the skydiving world. Well, that must continue. And that must be a major focus of that. Honesty and openness. Those are difficult words. Very difficult words, especially, you know, when we try and do something at council, at a committee, and suddenly the immediate reaction you get is not the, "Oh, thanks for the hours you've spent thinking about that." It's, "You moron, why did you do that? Why? That's going to make my life more difficult." And I think we need to proactively engage and listen to our members, you, our members, you know, and other stakeholders, seeking out your opinions, but also making sure we communicate our ambitions and what we're aiming to do. So you actually understand what we're trying to do, not just, "Oh, you've put a new restriction to my fun in place." But it's a two-way street. I'm asking that you treat us, your representatives, your volunteers, the staff, with respect integrity and trust. Trust, we're not just doing this to mess up your jumping weekend or to mess up whatever thing you think we're trying to mess up. We're actually doing it for a reason and try and understand what that reason is. What are we trying to achieve from it? Actually, treat us with respect. We will want to try and treat you with respect and integrity. And also, we want to continue to keep building on our knowledge. As I talked about earlier, you know, our safety management system is the envy of the world. Very easy to say, trips off the tongue, doesn't it? Almost. Trips off the tongue. But actually, the amount of hard work that's gone behind that, from our drop zone operators, from our instructors, from STC, from our various safety training officers that we've had over the years, the two, there's a lot of work there, and we must maintain that. But not just that, our knowledge in terms of competition, our knowledge in terms of governance, our knowledge in terms of safety safeguarding. Huge topic that when introduced in 2016, this time at the drop zone operators meeting, was almost booed out of the room. Yesterday, when it was discussed, it was the hottest topic. Everyone was so thankful that we'd been doing that, because in that meantime, Harvey Weinstein, the Jimmy Savills, the world is a changing, different place. And suddenly, safeguarding of you as our members, but not only that, as a drop zone, you as your customers, is very, very important. And we as your association need to be leading from the front, become matter experts in that, data protection, and other legislation which is coming down the line. So, enough of that talking, that kind of thing. Now comes the fun bit. Anyway, it's a video. Enjoy. For those that don't know, that was Jack doing the artistic landing in the pond there. I swear he's about a foot taller now. Anyway, out of that, obviously, highlights. Max setting a new British record, winning silver. Velocity winning bronze, European and World Champion World Cup. And indoor skydiving, female four-way, Volition. Skydive the Expo. Getting bigger and bigger every year. So great job, Adrian. Everyone else involved in that. It's fantastic. And I'd like to say, I hope everyone's downloaded the app, has planned their day. I did notice there are a few people whose arms definitely weren't long enough to be able to read. You know, maybe we need to do the programs in bigger font. Kev, yes, I am talking about you. I'd like to say thank you to our sponsors, Arch and Dialogue, our media partner, Romero, our insurance brokers, and Catlin XL, our insurers. So, quick review, our achievements in 2017. The opening of the new refurbished building. Whoa. British skydiving. It's going to be a biggie, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. Okay. I thought it was going to be. Maybe not. All right. Listen, choosing a logo is going to take us another 3 or 4 years. Don't you worry. Rise Up Mentoring Scheme. I think it's a great idea. You know, we talk about retaining members, showing love to those A and B licensed people. This is a way that we can all do that. I have a list of people who want to mentor me, apparently, but that's good. Our independents. I just want to say thank you very much for them. And later, our agenda item 9, Sue's up for renomination for that. But again, they've brought maybe not a sense of calm to the council table, because actually they create more issues than they solve, I think. But they certainly make us think about things a lot more. And the 5-year strategy, which I'm excited about. I'm not sure you guys are, but I'm excited about. It just means that I've got something to talk about for the next few years. And got some slides. Now, as I draw to the end, I noticed the plan for the expo is at 2 a.m. Up until 2 a.m., there's a disco, there's a band. 2 a.m., it finishes. And you have what I call the 2 a.m. question. And we have our 5-year strategy, pursuit of excellence. You know, engaging with communities. These are very important things. But really, this comes down to personal resilience. You need to ask yourself a question, 2 a.m. Do I need another drink? Just be warned, you will be on my slides next year. Thank you very, very much. That finishes my... Oi, we're not finished, Kev. Got another hour to go. Okay, so that gets us to agenda item 5. Oh, we're whipping through this. Okay, to receive and adopt, if approved, the annual report. So that is the official document you will have all received in your mag, and obviously is downloadable. Before we go through to that, we are very happy, by H, thanks for coming. We'll throw it open to questions. So if anyone has any questions on either my report to you as the AGM, the BPA review of the year 2017, or the annual report, please feel free to ask any questions now. Go on. No? All right then. Okay, so could I have someone propose, accept, thank you. Someone seconding accepting the annual report, thank you. Anyone against? Any abstentions? So approved. Okay, agenda item 6. This is this is exciting stuff. To reappoint the auditors and allow council to fix their remuneration. And our auditors are... Haynes Watts, HW, Haynes Watts, Chartered Accountants. Fucking on it, on it. Yeah. A proposer. No, I need a proposer. Thank you. A seconder. Thank you. Anyone against? Abstentions? Approved. Okay. Agenda item 7. This might get some interest. I hand you over to Madam Treasurer.
Good morning, everyone. I think we do have some slides here. We love a slide, don't we? I would like to propose that the overall subscription goes down.
Small things, please, small minds, is all I'm going to say.
Don't get overexcited by your 51p. But this is a result, one, of the management of the finances we do, but also the management of safety that goes on, which means that we can continue to have a lower insurance element. So keep up with the safety guys, and we hope this trend can continue. So could I have a proposer and a seconder for these numbers, please? Thank you. And then,
anyone against? Any abstentions? I think we'll find that's passed.
Thank you. A new item this year is we are actually also going to put forward the provisional memberships to the meeting. Previously, this has happened at a meeting in December, but we're bringing it all together. So I would similarly like to propose that the provisional member subscription goes down from £16.81 to £16.60. So could we have a proposer and seconder for that, please?
Thank you
very much. Anyone against? Thank you.
Pretty straightforward. Oh, lost that. Three people were elected, which was Paul Applegate, Adrian Bond, and Georgie Vasher. So congratulations. And obviously the first council meeting of the year, January, it immediately follows the awards ceremony over at the hotel. Thank you. Agenda item 9 is to... It's a lot there, isn't it? Basically, to appoint the independent non-executive director. So we have a nominations committee that met last year and recommends to you as the AGM that we reappoint Sue as independent director. Can I have a nomination? Sorry, a proposer for that? Thank you. A seconder? Brilliant. Anyone against? Any abstentions? Thank you. Congratulations, Sue. You are reappointed for 3 years. Yeah. Thank you very much. That brings to a close. I know it's felt a long time, isn't it? The formal business of the AGM. So up next is the awards ceremony with Brian Vasher doing the presentation and the awards there. So just really for me to say thank you very, very much for your time today. Have a very safe and fun 2018.